I've lived in Ryderwood roughly 30 years.
I was born here in 1936. And my brother was born here in 1938.
Me and my family came here in 1942, right after the war broke out.
Well, I was born in 1942 here in the first aid station, which is now called Pioneer Hall, along with hundreds of other babies born to logger families during those logging years.
Ryderwood has a history.
Originated in 1923 by the Longview Lumber Company, and they were in business until 1953, so it was the first logging town built for loggers and their families.
The logging community was a first of its kind. It had never been done before. There are logging communities that are older than Ryderwood, but they were a descendant of a railroad community or an Indian community or some other group that came and went, and then the logging came in, so those communities grew up. The Ryderwood was created out of the woods, and it was specifically used for a certain purpose, and that was specific, and it's one of a kind.
The community spirit that was here during the logging years was really strong because there was a mutual goal. They were to get the old growth timber out, and they took out over 500,000 log cars in the process.
I think of significance is the community hall was the first large building that they put up. The office building or the company store was built pretty much the same time, but the fact that the sense of community was so important to R.A. Long that was the first building built.
You know, you didn't have any electric bill, you didn't have a garbage bill, you didn't have a water bill, and if you didn't have a doctor bill, if you wanted to come up here to the infirmary, the doctor was paid by Long Bell. He was not paid by the individuals. And so if you got sick or you were injured and you ended up at the first aid station, that was on the company.
We knew everybody in town. We could roam around town, it wasn't a problem. 10 o'clock at night, we could still be out. Mom would step out and whistle like she could. When we heard that whistle, we knew it was time to come home. The big buildings are the church and the community hall, and well, the post office and the library. We call it the library, it was originally a cafe. Those are all original, plus about 140 plus houses are still in existence today.
I was a paper carrier here. I had 116 dailies and 97 Sundays. That's how many people lived here. And that's why I knew so many people, because I delivered the papers.
You know, they didn't have any liquor sold in Ryderwood ever in 30 years because it was against his beliefs. It was a mile out of town, and you wanted to walk out there and you get sober by the time you came home. That was one of the things we knew about. Of course, there was an awful lot of liquor in Ryderwood. It was a logging camp, of course, but it was never sold.
We'd come home at noon, Mom would have the washing done, and she'd have a tub full of clothes ready to hang out. Sister and I'd come home at lunchtime and take those clothes and hang them on the lines out back. You know, it was wonderful, wonderful way to grow up.
In 1950, we heard rumors that the town was going to be sold. So everybody was scrambling to see where they could be moved to or where they could move.
Instead of the 80 to 100 years that was initially planned, it took 30 years. Technology advanced things, and by the time the Depression rolled around in the early 30s, when they were reduced to half the number of loggers who started.
When the logging quit in 1952, the families had to leave here, and my family went to Oregon. Dad got work down there, so he moved the family to Myrtle Creek. Then in 1953, pretty much the loggers and the logs were gone, and they were in the process of sort of tearing the place down when an innovative investor, real estate investor, said, I bet we can buy that whole town and make it into a retirement community. So that's exactly what they did.
They just kind of spread out, and that way we lost track of a lot of people, you know. But then they started doing this, which is really nice, having a get-together, ceremony-like.
1954 was the first one held in this area, and it was held at Sequest Park, and there were several hundred people showed up. It was busy. I was there. That was the year before I left the area. And the second time I came back was in 1974, and my father said, it's time for you to go back and see the reunion, and I was here in this park for that.
The old timers group, of course, is being reduced in numbers every year, and we're basically now working with the families of the loggers. The loggers are gone, basically. But those of us who grew up here and were around each other and in that history have things to share.
I mean, it's sort of a joke here around town because we call them the old timers, but we're all old timers too. You know, it's just that we're not, most of us aren't quite as old as most of them. But understandably, there's fewer and fewer of them every year. So that's why we felt like it was really important to try to capture this.
The old timers would come here, they'd rent the park, and they'd go, and they never saw or met or got involved with any of the people who lived here.
That came up when we realized, of course, we had the two histories. One of the goals from the outset was building bridges between the two.
We didn't get involved with the old timers reunion until about 3 years ago. One of our members, who you will meet, made the comment at one of our history project meetings, said, well, you know, old Ryderwood wasn't real sure whether new Ryderwood wanted us here. So we were bound and determined to change that.
Yeah,
but that's the one you knew about. Right?
Yeah, that's the one I knew. And then we moved it out by the
U.S. citizenship, and there was a couple. I know they lived up with the skid shacks.
Yeah, a lot of fond memories of this place. But I would tell anybody that knows about the town to please come and visit, because there is a history here.
This has got such a unique history. It's a special little corner of the world here.
The people who come here to visit, to answer your question, They see a well-tended town. They see people who, for the most part, are happy to be here. They see a high level of community spirit and volunteer spirit. And all that was here in the earlier history as well as the current one.
Peaceful, quiet village in the woods, and people love it. Thank you.